Excited. Excited to get the season going. It's been a good 3 weeks of camp. You know, I had a couple injuries early that we were trying to overcome. Some kids lost for the year, but we were able to get out of this last week and relatively healthy. And had practice yesterday morning and get into this afternoon. So today's first day of school, so that's always game week and first day of school. So that's a busy day. But, you know, like I said, had a good camp. You know, so kind of excited to get to play somebody else. Obviously a great, you know, SEC opponent. Missouri on the road with, you know, some outstanding players, a first round draft pick and their quarterback, and some other good players to go along with that. So certainly a challenge, and, you know, but we'll leave out of here on Friday and we'll go play.
Obviously there's a difference between camp practice and mm-hmm. game preparation practice. But talk about the mentality change from what you've been doing for the last 3 weeks and what you're starting to do today going into the weekend.
Yeah, it's you know, your game plan, you start getting more specific on stuff, different fronts, different coverages, different, you know, so both teams are, you know, different things. So you get more specific on how you block things, how you read things. You know, it's coaches is fun. It is. From a player standpoint, they're just ready to play a game. And they kind of tolerate us as we, you know, give them a plan and get ready to go. But there'll be, you know, a lot more spring in the step of the players. As, like I said, as they're, you know, they're getting ready to play, you know, another color helmet this week. And, you know, on SEC Network, so that's a big thrill for our kids as well.
I know you guys have probably looked at Missouri over the course of the last several weeks, and probably since the game was scheduled right over the summer and off season stuff. But do you show any of that to the kids? That they have you made them?
Yeah, they've seen some, and you know, it's you're trying to get them to look at it just schematically. Okay, you know, this is a four-man front. This is the coverage they play. This is their, you know, base runs, base down distance, things like that. You know, and as coaches, you're trying to do that as well. But then you also run into some, you know, then when you start looking at it just by personnel, okay, that look how big this guy is that plays this position, look how fast he is, and same thing as secondary, same thing with the offensive line. Obviously, you know, larger people than we play against, you know, in our conference. And our players know that, just like against Ole Miss last year and some of the other teams this group of seniors has played in the past. But you can't control that, so, you know, that you don't even talk about that. You do what you do on offense and defense that gives you the best chance so your kids can play fast and can have fun and fly around and give themselves a chance to compete.
You got a lot of new faces on this team that hasn't played this kind of game mm-hmm. before. Right. What do you say to them?
We talked about it a little bit yesterday, addressed it in team meeting from the standpoint of, hey, enjoy this largest crowd they play against and we play in front of all year. You know, so enjoy that. Don't let that you know, deter you from your you know, between the lines, 100-yard field, that whole, you know, Hoosier speech, you know, 10 yards for a first down, that type of stuff. But embrace the crowd, the environment, enjoy that. And so, you know, then my job this week, and we had some dress rehearsals to make sure they know how to get in the locker room, what's going to happen at halftime, what's going to happen in pregame, what's going to happen on the sideline in between series and stuff to allow them to get comfortable and to just play.
Can you talk about the injuries that you just mentioned? How did they affect your planning?
We had to shuffle some things offensive line wise. We lost Kyle Nace was battling at that for the starting center job, starting guard job. So, you know, a guy could play two positions for us. So we lost him for the year, and that affected us. I had to reshuffle some things, you know, up front. Lost a linebacker, Deion Goldborn, that gave us some length, especially do some things on special teams and rushing the passer. So that affects some depth at the linebacker position. And then the other three guys we lost, two other linebackers we lost during spring. They're out, and then a running back who was a bigger back for us. And Deshaun Fields with ACL. So, you know, five guys, and then, you know, Ty Brown's out with mono for the next 4 or 5 weeks. And I hate that, his senior year, but we'll get him back hopefully, you know, in the middle of the year, and he can finish out his senior year because he's worked really hard, just like all those kids. But for a senior, Nace and Ty Brown, that's you know, it's sad. It's an unforgiving sport. It is, based on the physicality of it, and then how many, you know, you only get 11 opportunities. And so when you miss one, two of them, you missed over, you know, a higher percentage of games than than that seems fair sometimes.
What are your expectations from this group, Coach? I know last year I asked you that question, and you said, you know, last year's team you thought was one of the better that you had, but it didn't work out. So what's your expectation for this bunch?
You know, I don't think we really know yet. I mean, the expectation, the goals are the same. I think you got to play. You got to play some games to know how people, you know, physically wise, how tall, how fast, and stuff. There's some improvements at a lot of positions. How we play on Saturdays, you know, in between the lines. You know, I'll know that a couple games under our belt to see where we're deficient and who excels in that type of competition, who can break tackles, who, you know, which quarterback can make plays under any pressure and stuff. I think that's, when you find those things out, then you kind of know what's realistic of, you know, of where the team can get to. That's how I look at it anyway.
Talk about your backfield and Dresser.
Yeah, you know, like both quarterbacks, both, you know, expect both of them to be able to play. You know, Dresser's got 5 starts under his belt, and you know, probably just a little ahead of JoJo from a standpoint of just he's been there, done that, and so when you make adjustments, game plan wise, he's been through that, and JoJo is catching back up, but he's very talented athletically in the way he runs and throws and stuff. So he brings, I won't say a different component of the offense. He just brings another athletic component to that position. So I like that. And then in the backfield, we're probably deeper at tailback this year than we were last year, getting Juice back. And Galloway's had a really good camp. He really has. He's had a really good camp. And Peyton Logan's done good things back there at the tailback spot. And then we've added Keemon Abrams from Butler Community College, and he gives us a different, you know, he's made some big plays in camp. So I like those guys, those 4 guys in the backfield. We're pretty talented. We get the balls in those guys' hands.
To have those guys in the backfield and more of them and more bodies to have, does that make it easier on your quarterbacks in a lot of different ways, not just the option of handing it off and giving them a little time to let the game develop around, but also options in the passing game as well?
No, it does. I mean, you know, the checking the ball down to our backs is a great thing, we feel like anyway, and they're all pretty good pass protectors. But I think more importantly, it helps you in practice from the standpoint to where you got 4 guys, you're able to split reps up, and you have to practice at a certain level. There's another guy that will get your reps in practice, so that pushes guys. And you know, you wish you had 4 guys at multiple positions, but that, with that type of athleticism.
I can only imagine offensive lines looking forward to blocking for these guys this year.
Well, we hope so. I hope so. You know, they, like I said, they had some good camp, ran the ball well at times. You know, I guess we're starting 3 seniors. 3 seniors up front, our center, our right guard, and our left tackle. So 3 seniors. So, you know, 2 of those guys have been here for a long time. So it's good to get them. I guess Big Mark, then Nick Allen at the left tackle. This will be, I think, their first start for us. Okay, but they've, you know, been here, been in our systems for a while, and I guess it'll be Terry Fultz, our right tackle, be his first start for us as well. So I guess I hadn't thought about it like that, but I guess realistically, 4 of the 5 starters, this will be their first start. Yeah, Nick Thomas, you know, started last year for us, Memphis transfer at the center position.
Talk about your defense and how it's preparing to go up against Missouri.
You know, it's challenging because of the standpoint of, you know, the big, obviously when you're big up front, you're explosive in the pass game. Obviously, that's going to put you in some conflicts and some bonds and stuff. But you know, my goal for them is to, you know, fit gaps, use our speed, use our athleticism. Obviously, we're going to be outmatching from a size standpoint, all right? But our guys will compete, and they'll fight, and they'll chase the football. And, you know, you've got to try to be opportunistic, you know, try to get some balls out of there, try to get them some third longs, and, you know, get off the field and get your offense back there. I mean, that's no, you know, there's no special math equation that comes to staying in a game like this. You got to get a turnover. You got to score touchdowns in the red zone. Those type of things.
You gonna use a 2 quarterback system, Coach?
I don't necessarily say it's a 2 quarterback system. I just think we've got a second guy that's a good player, and especially early in the year before you get the conference. you know, you want to get that guy some experience because he has not played, you know, in a game for us, even though because he redshirted last year. So, you know, hopefully there's an opportunity to be able to do that. But, you know, we'll see. You know, there's going to be nothing planned out this series or that series, nothing like that. I just think I'd like to get him some playing time his first couple games to get ready to go in when we get back home here in 2 weeks.
How does opening the season at Missouri really help this team as it kind of progresses in the conference season?
I don't know that it does. I don't know that it does help you. We've done it so many different ways. You know, we played NAI opponents first. We played, non-conference opponent first, FCS, and then we played, some SEC guys early. I mean, it's exciting for the players. That part's good. Sometimes you get to go on the road the first game. Sometimes you really get to kind of galvanize your team a little bit because there is less distractions because you're getting on a bus for 5 hours, you're traveling together, you're eating together. That part helps you going into next week when you got to go back on the road again. I think it helps you when you are able to go be competitive and you play hard and you say, hey, win, lose, or draw, we're going to have a good football team, you know. But doesn't always, you know, Ole Miss, by the middle of the year, injuries or not playing as well, you know, it didn't, did it help us or hurt us? We still ended up 4-4 in the league. So one thing I have learned to do after being a head coach now for 13 years is never let a first game, second game define you. Because, you can not finish strong and be 4-4 in the league, or your team can find itself and you can, you know, rewrite a different chapter as you go forward. And so you can't put everything into that first game. I mean, you prepare and you play and you go, but you can't say we're going to be, man, look how good we're going to be, or we're not going to be as good. I mean, we beat Memphis in, 2012. That was a great win for us. And we had Northern Illinois the next week and still play good. And now we had a good team. I think we went 8-3, but we didn't win the league. So we faltered down the road and lost the game on the road against Tennessee Tech. So that's one thing that I've talked to our seniors about is, hey, play as hard as you can. But guess what? If you're judged over 11-game series, not just one.
Anything else?
Thanks, guys. Thank you all so much.
Thanks, Coach.